and now these teams look to continue either a strong start or build on something that maybe wasn't the best start as we begin the real bulk of this schedule in the Marble Champions 2021. Hello again, friends. I'm Keanu Bitterzicki. Glad to be here on behalf of Marble Fubica for today's event. This is our second event of the 2021 Marble Champions. A more traditional event, as you see the starting gates for this sprint-style event today. An opportunity for these teams to show off their speed after a little bit more skill and precision was needed in our first event. This one's pure speed. It's just a long sprint right in front of the home stretch and all the fans in the stands. Glad to have them here as always. And there is the entire course. The starting gate's up the front on the left side. On the right side, you'll have the finishing gate. Here are the overall standings after one event. Swiftblade won our opening event, so they are in the lead with 20 points, leading by 3 over the Snowwolves, who took silver, and the Archangels, who took a bronze, leading the group. But everybody really still in it after just one event. The teams are ready. The fans are ready. Are you ready? This is event number 2 of the 2021 Marble Champions. This is the sprint race. So again, as you see, this course, typically, you'll see winds and curves and different obstacles for these marbles to avoid. That is not the case today. All about pure speed. Here are the groupings for today's event. Different groups. The style will work the same. Top two from each group will advance to the semifinals. Top two from each semifinal will advance into our finale. We'll start with Group A. They are the Steel Brothers, Tatu Bola, Snowwolves, and Flush. And they come out of the gates. Here we go. And out in front, it looks like it's Flush and Steel Brothers coming across the line. Steel Brothers takes the lead, and Flush takes the second advancement place. They get the transfer spot over the Snowwolves, who finish third. Tatu Bola finishes in last in that grouping, and so they will not advance. You can see Flush in the green. Look like they got out to the lead at first. Those are the silver marbles of the Steel Brothers. Not surprising based on the name. And there is the pass for the lead right at the end. A little bit of contact between the top two finishers. Let's have a look. And everything within at least a marble length there. Nothing too crazy. And so the Flush and the Steel Brothers will advance into the first semifinal out of Group A. Group B, the Janitors, the Fury Spiders, the Archangels, and the Savage Jackal. They release, and right now it looks like it's the Savage Jackal in the lead, followed by the Fury Spiders. But here come the Janitors, and did the Savage Jackal advance? They did. They just beat out the Archangels. And the Janitors come from behind after running in third or fourth for the majority of that short sprint. Let's see where that run happens. They run the fastest time so far at a 4.945. Yeah, they just picked up a lot of speed toward the end. How close was it for second? Looks like it was pretty close. Pretty close all the way around. The exception really of fourth place. Looked like the Sphery Spiders weren't really in it as much as the other three, but that was a tight run there. So the Janitors and the Savage Jackal advance into the semifinal. They will take on Flush and the Steel Brothers. Moving to Group C, this is the Vikings, the Trojans, the Onyx, and the Orus One. Out of the gates, and it's the Trojans and the Vikings in the lead, and they look like they've got a pretty big lead. Yeah, it's just no matter who's going to win, it's the Trojans. Pretty significant there. That was over 2/10 of a second between second and third, and it was never close. Orus 1 finished third. Onyx takes fourth, but neither will advance, obviously, through one of those transfer spots of the group stage. And the Trojans led wire to wire there. The Vikings with a strong finish as well to take second place, and they both advance into semifinal B. And the final grouping will include Swiftblade, our points standings leader. Also the Lynx Ruffus, Speedy Hunters, and the Blue Jackets. And they are off. Bad start for Swiftblade. It's the Speedy Hunters and the Blue Jackets. They will advance. Exactly a 10th of a second between second and third. That was Swiftblade. And almost another full 10th back to the Lynx Ruffus. They struggled. Let's have a look. It just looked like Lynx Ruffus banging off the walls caused some problems. side by side for the majority of the race for first place. But in these group stages, you only need to be first or second. Wow, yeah, it was close coming across the line for who was going to win the state or win the group staging here, but not close for who's going to advance. It was a pretty easy win there for the top two. We have another look at it. Let's see, coming across the line, how close? Pretty close. And so that will move the Blue Jackets and the Speedy Hunters into semifinal B. Here's the first semifinal. We go back to the Janitors, the Savage Jackal, the Steel Brothers, and Lush. Janitors have the fastest time so far. Can they do it again? They are in the lead. Here is the Flush in second. Savage Jackal making a run. Cannot get it done. The Janitors and Flush advance. Savage Jackal and the Steel Brothers will have to settle for a 5th through 8th place finish. Savage Jackal made a run there. Yeah, the Janitors are just... they're pretty darn fast right now. It'll be interesting to see if they keep that through the final. If they do, there's nobody that's going to beat them. They have the most speed right now. Let's see if they're able to get a clean run in the final, because they're in, as are Flush. Savage Jackal made a strong run. Steel Brothers struggle, in fact, because they made contact there with the Janitors. They never crossed the finish line. So the Janitors and Flush are into the final. And now semifinal B, with the Trojans, the Speedy Hunters, the Blue Jackets, and the Vikings. There we go. And right now it's the Vikings and the Blue Jackets in the lead. Here come the Trojans. They're going to take over second place. They're going to get it done at the line. And that was the fastest time. Yeah, the Vikings just ran a faster time than the Janitors did in the first round, which was the fastest time to that point. A 4.658 is the best time now of this event, and it belongs to the Vikings, and they do it en route to a semifinal win and an advancement into the final, and did it. Did it by a pretty large margin. Second place was pretty close. The Trojans got it done. And so they get to fight for a win here in the sprint race. Blue Jackets were close, but just could not get enough at the end. So moving into the final. Here we go. Flush, Trojans, the Janitors, and the Vikings. And they're off. And if it's not the Janitors or the Trojans, it'd be a shock. They are side by side, cutting in front, and getting the win are the Janitors. Unbelievable move. Shut the door. Have another look at it, and that was a great move by the Janitors. Pretty strong run by Flush as well to stay up there with those top two that clearly have the speed. Almost looked like there was some drafting going on. As Flush tried to go from one side to another, and watch right here. You can see cutting a little bit farther in front, just clearing the Trojans, and that's where the Janitors make their move, shut the door, and will win this one. Boy, that was an unbelievable move. We'll see it again from this angle. I mean, you just can't do it better than that. So the Janitors get the win and do it with one speed and two. A great move to make sure that they stayed in front of the Trojans. They are the winners of event number two, the sprint race. And congratulations to them. A huge win for them, and a show that clearly the Janitors have speed. And so you better watch out if you're doing a speed event here in the Marvel Champions League in 2021, because the Janitors may just be the team to beat if that's the case. Great run by them. They'll make their way up to the podium, as well as our second and third place finishers. They're the ones that get the big trophy. Look at the overall standings from today. The results, the Janitors pick up 20 points with that win. The Trojans finish second, Flush third, Vikings fourth, and the Savage Jackal fifth. They're all the way down to Onyx, Lynx Ruffus, and Tatu Bola, who finish in the final last three positions. In fact, that fourth last position was actually Swiftblade. So Swiftblade's going to drop to fourth. The Janitors take a 4-point lead. It's a tie for second between the Trojans and Flush. They each have a medal. gold for the janitors as they get it done today and get it done in pretty impressive fashion. It was a show of speed and a show of precision as well at the end with that move to cut in front of the Trojans and not allow any kind of last second shenanigans from them. So they get the win. Congratulations on behalf of Marble Fubica for today's event. Our grand arena once again today, as we are two events through, and now just one speed event and one skill event. We should go back to the skill side of things. There's the cup that they'll be fighting for today and throughout the remainder of this season. Let's have a look at how the teams are doing so far. Right now, the overall leaders are the Janitors by 4 points over the Trojans and Flush. Swiftblade, after a win in event number one, has dropped to fourth. The Janitors are the leaders. They are ready. The teams are ready. The fans are ready. Let's do it. It's event number three of the 2021 Marble Champions. This is the Soccer Dribble. As you have a look at this soccer field down there with the Marble Champions and Marble Fubica logo, and there are some obstacles to navigate. A couple of goals down at the end, and we'll see what this event is all about. As you can see there, got some scoring opportunities. You know how it works in terms of the setup for today's tournament. As always here in the Marble Champions League, the groupings change, so there are the groups for you. We begin with Group A, which is the Vikings, the Lynx Rufus, the Blue Jackets, and the Steel Brothers. They are off, and we'll see who can get through. And a couple of goals, maybe. There's one and another. And the Vikings score at the very end. They advance, as do the Steel Brothers, Lynx Rufus, and the Blue Jackets. They were the first to get down, but they do not score a goal. And they are eliminated with 2 and 1 points, respectively, as you see them go down on either side right there. Have a look. Easy goal for the Steel Brothers, and a little bit of a knock there from the goalie. Almost cost the Vikings their goal. But they are able to advance, as well as the Steel Brothers, into the first semifinal. And here's Group B. This is Tatu Bola, Snow Wolves, the Janitors, and the Speedy Hunters. So our leaders are a part of this group. Let's see where the scoring goes, and nobody will score a goal. The Snow Wolves picked up 4. The Speedy Hunters pick up 2. And so the Janitors are championship leaders, as well as Tatu Bola. They are eliminated here in the group stage. Let's have another look and see how it happened. You can see up at the top of the screen there, yeah, even coming out of the lines there, not a good run at all for the Janitors. Not really a good run for anybody. Nobody got close to a goal whatsoever. But good enough for the Snow Wolves and the Speedy Hunters. They are advancing into semifinal A. And so the group stage moves to Group C, which consists of the Savage Jackal, the Trojans, the Onyx, and the Flush. And let's see what happens. Do we have a goal? Oh, we almost did. The Onyx picked up 2, nearly scored a goal. They'll still advance, as do the Savage Jackal. And the Trojans, by way of the time that it took them to score, are going to be eliminated after a three-way tie with 2 points. The Trojans did it in the slowest time, as we'll see here on the replay. And so it will cost them their opportunity to advance into the next round. For what it's worth, they were significantly slower, so at least it wasn't a close one there. But still a disappointing end for the Trojans. And then the Flush unable to advance as well, as we make our way to the final group, including our first event winner. That's Swiftblade. The rest of the group, Oris 1, the Sphery Spiders, and the Archangels. And will we get a goal? The goalkeeper's going to block that shot. The Archangels will not score. They're eliminated, as are Swiftblade, Oris 1, and Sphery Spiders. They're advancing from Group D. How about that move from the goaltender there? Not allowing the Archangels to score, which would have almost guaranteed, even if they had not gone in the goal, they probably would have scored right off to the side, which was 4 points, would have advanced. Instead, the Archangels unable to score. Wow. And so they are eliminated, as are Swiftblade. And so therefore, Swiftblade and the Janitors, both eliminated in this group stage, we will for the third time have a different winner here through three events. Moving on to the semifinals, First semifinal, it's the Speedy Hunters, the Snow Wolves, the Vikings, the Steel Brothers. Two advance. Here's a two. There's an eight. There's a goal. Two on the side. Let's see. Two in the middle, and it will cost the Speedy Hunters. So the Steel Brothers, who got down there the fastest by a pretty significant margin, almost a full second ahead of anybody else. And they were, what was that, somewhere around the four-second range higher than any of the other three that scored 2 points. There was their two. There was the goal. And then the last two, both scoring 2 points, one all the way on the bottom of the screen. There it is. Other right through the middle, made contact with the post, and it costs the Speedy Hunters. As the Vikings and the Steel Brothers, both out of Group A, advancing into the finals, of the two members from Group B to advance done in the semifinal. Here is semifinal B. Onyx, Savage Jackal, Oris One, and the Siri Spiders. They go down hectically. There's two, another two, another two, and a one. Onyx, the last of the twos to get down. They're eliminated, as are the Savage Jackal, the only team not to score two. They put up just 1 point, and so Oris One and the Sphery Spiders advancing into the final for today's event. Again, not super close. In fact, it was the Onyx who were the slowest, despite the fact that they'll finish ahead of the Savage Jackal because they did score more points there. And so the final is set. The Vikings, the Steel Brothers, the Sphery Spiders, and the Onyx. As you have a look at the crowd for these four teams, hoping to see something amazing. So here we go. Vikings, Steel Brothers, Sphery Spiders, Oris One for the win. Here we go. Who's first down? It might be the Steel Brothers. They've got two. There's a three and a win for Oris One. They were the slowest, but they score the most. Just got it done at the end. A silver for the Steel Brothers. The Vikings, by virtue of time, pick up the bronze, and the Sphery Spiders will finish in fourth. In today's event, there are the fans. Congratulations to them as Oris One advances all the way through and wins this one. Just barely advancing out of the second semifinal. Let's have a look at the replay here, and you can see they're not the fastest, although they weren't the slowest to begin with. Once that contact was made, really slowed them down. There's a lot of contact there with the Sphery Spiders as well. Right there, that contact made with that orange marker may have been the one to kind of set them up for that success. And there they go with the win, across the line, 3 points, and a victory. Congratulations to them, as Oris One becomes our third different winner through three events. An interesting event here with the soccer dribble. Have a look at our fans again in attendance for today's event, and in just a second we'll have a look at the standings, see where it looked first at the results of today's events, and then what that does with the overall standings of this tournament, the 2021 Marble Champions League. And here are the results from today. So Oris One gets the win, the Steel Brothers second, Vikings third, Sphery Spiders fourth, and Onyx picked up the fifth place. All the way down through the rest of that crowd, here are the overall standings. Oris One and the Steel Brothers now in a tie for the lead. The Snow Wolves are third, the Vikings are fourth. The Janitors drop from first to fifth after failing to get out of the group stage today. And so they have work to do. As you have a look at the podium today, 31 points now after that third place finish, 31 points on the season for the Vikings, and a tie atop the standings between our top two finishers from today's event, the Steel Brothers at 35 points and Oris One at 35 points. Congratulations to both of those teams, but today everybody aspires to be Oris One, as they're the winners of event number 3 of the 2021 Marble Champions League here on Marble Fubica. They will look to continue that momentum and now maybe break a tie for that lead, as it is definitely heating up as we get closer and closer.
Jugar con mis ilusiones, porque cuando se te antoja rompes.
Eres mi talón de Aquiles, mi punto más vulnerable. Ser un muñeco de trapo que tenga ojos de botones. Afortunadamente, imposible es que no duela despertar de un cuento de hadas y llorar al darme cuenta que amo un maniquí.